Chronic low back pain, which is very prevalent, it's actually about 80%, 85% of the patient of the people population will get at least one episode of low back pain during their lifetime. It accounts to about almost half of the chronic pain patients. It's divided to specific or non-specific. There are actually certain red flags with them if you get an infection, neurological deficits like cardiac angina, or malignancy. The other sort of problems with it are degenerative disease, failed back surgery, syndrome, as well as central spinal cord, spinal stenosis, or central canal stenosis, facet joint syndrome, joint syndrome, or sacroiliitis, disc prolapse with or without nerve compression. Most commonly, they have actually no specific cause. Chronic pain, high prevalence, is about 20% of the patient population report having some form of back pain. The aim of the treatment, you want to promote effective self-management of the symptoms, and you want to mainly maximize their function and minimize their disability. The modalities that we use, we want to make sure that you want to discourage, but just try to keep them as active as possible. You don't advise for a specific back exercises. Reassure the patient that usually the prognosis is favorable. Encourage them to stay active, as I said, and you need to prescribe basic analgesic if necessary. You can consider spinal manipulation, as well as you can start with paracetamol in mild cases. You can consider adding NSAIDs, and then if you want to use a short-term opioid, consider the risk-benefit ratio. But we're not recommending you the use of benzodiazepines. Acute non-specific low back pain, start with paracetamol non-steroidals. Education is important. You have to keep them extremely active. Self-efficacy and spinal manipulation is helpful. Heat trap, usually therapy, is helpful, as well as multidisciplinary input is quite crucial in such patients. In chronic non-specific low back pain, usually non-tricyclic antidepressant can be started. And NSAIDs, you can actually get them into a supervised exercise program, an intensive multidisciplinary treatment program, physiotherapy, psychotherapy, and pain specialist, acupuncture, spinal manipulation, and there's fair evidence for the use of opioid in these patients. Root compression, spinal manipulation usually does help. The use of antiepileptic like gabapentin or pregabalin can be helpful. The use of NSAIDs is potentially helpful. I discourage against use the I'd rather not use system steroids, since it's actually not extremely helpful in such cases. Chronic non-specific low back pain, lumbar fusion usually is better in unstructured conservative therapy, but it's not better than multidisciplinary approach. So there's a major debate in the literature at the moment whether you go for the surgical treatment or the intensive multidisciplinary non-surgical treatment, including epidural steroid psychotherapy and physiotherapy. We don't have a right answer to it, and yet either or it depends on patient individual case by case.